This problem deals with an endothermic reaction that can be run in a CSTR or a PFR. All right, and so we're looking at a comparison between a 100 liter adiabatic CSTR and a 100 liter adiabatic PFR. We're told that in the CSTR the conversion is 40%, and we just want to know if the conversion in the PFR will be greater than, less than, or equal to 40%. All right, so in this case, we have the fact that the rate of reaction is equal to a reaction rate constant, which is a function of temperature. The question is, what will the temperature be in the two reactors? All right, and so in a CSTR, we have a well-mixed situation. And so the temperature in the reactor will be equal to the temperature at which we have the conversion of 40%. And the temperature in a plug flow type reactor, which is the same size in this case, will actually vary down the length of the reactor. So it's going to start at the feed temperature, and then this is an endothermic reaction, and so the temperature will decrease until the final conversion. So we will have a variable value for the rate constant. All right, to see how this is going to vary in an adiabatic reaction, right, we can plot the relationship between conversion and temperature in this adiabatic reaction. All right, and what we expect is that as the reaction proceeds and the conversion of our reactant goes up, then the temperature is going to go down. That will be approximately, over a smaller temperature range, a linear relationship, as we can see from an energy balance, but that actually doesn't affect the result, so we won't bother deriving that. But so what happens is that a CSTR will operate at the final value of the conversion, the 40% conversion, and its rate constant will be at that temperature, right? Whereas in a PFR, we'll be operating at all of these temperatures, right, as we go up to a higher and higher conversion. And so that means the rate constant will actually be higher in the beginning region of the PFR. And so because of that, for the same volume PFR, we'll be able to achieve a higher conversion than in a CSTR, because we're going to have a higher reaction rate inside that reactor.